Let us see the circuit analysis in a external magnetic field. Let us see how to do the circuit analysis. System is provided like this. There is a frame and this is moving with speed v. The magnetic field is B. Okay, now this frame part has got a resistance of R1, this has got R2, and this wire has got an internal resistance of R. So obviously, because of the motion of the movable frame, there will be a induced current in this loop. So we need to analyze this system. So I will draw the actual circuit. See, when the magnetic field is like this and it is moving towards right, in the previous videos we have discussed that if you take this point as P and Q, P will be at higher potential. Okay, so this will look something like this. This circuit will look okay. This is the internal resistance, this is R1, R2, this is the higher potential, so this is the positive terminal, negative terminal. Let us say the current I is going from here, it branches out into I1 and I2. Now we want to find out what is this current. Now because this is the case of motional EMF, the E value will be V times VL. L is the length of the frame, V is the speed with which this frame is moving, and V is the magnetic field. Okay, now this I value will be E divided by R dash. You can see here this R1 and R2, they are in parallel. Okay, so they are in parallel. So because they are in parallel, what is the effective resistance between them? It is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. These two combined is this. This is in series with R. So the R dash value will be how much? It will be E divided by R dash will be R plus R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So if you simplify this, you get E times R1 plus R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. This is the value of I. You can substitute the value of E, which is this. It becomes BVL R1 plus R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. Now observe here, these two are in parallel. So in their inverse ratio, the current will be distributed. What do I mean by that? If this R1 and R2 are 10 and 20, so how much will be I1 means? This is R1, let us say, this is R2. I will be I multiplied by, for R1 I need to write R2, 20 divided by 10 plus 20. Okay, so I1 will be I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2, and I2 will be I into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So let us put the values here. I, we have got this much, BVL into R1 plus R2, BVL into R1 plus R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. This is the value of I multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So here this and this goes off, you get dVL R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R. This is the value of I1. So how to get the I2 value means, I2 value you can find either I minus I1, or you can put this formula. So which you will finally get dVL in place of R2, you will get R1 R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R. This is one approach what we have seen. Okay. So can we find out the currents using our Kirchhoff rules? Yes, we can find out using the Kirchhoff rule also. So in the Kirchhoff rule, let us say I apply to P, Q, R, S and P. If I apply KVL to P, Q, R, S, P, what will I get? The current flow is like this. So this will be my plus, minus. This will be my plus, minus. Minus, plus. So I1 into, there is a potential drop. I1 into R1 with a minus sign. Again there is a plus to minus. So here you see I1 is coming and here I2 is coming. So this is again I2 and this is again I1. So it will become again I. So minus, minus because it is plus to minus. I into R. Minus to plus. So it is the EMF, it is plus E is equal to 0. Okay. So therefore E is equal to IR plus I1 R. This is what we have got. And we are trying to find out the value of I1. Okay. So here, so what is the value of I? See, I in both the cases it will be, whether you are calculating by the previous method or by this method, we need to, what is the value of I means, I will be E divided by R dash only, right? So if it is E divided by R dash, just a minute. So this is what we have got. E is equal to IR plus. What is I1? You see here, if it is parallelly connected, we have got this expression I1 is equal to IR2 by R1 plus R. So we will just put this value over here. I into IR2 by R1 plus R2 into R1. Right? This is what it is. So you can take I common, you are getting R plus R1 by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay. So this is I is equal to R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2 whole divided by R1 plus R2. So what is the value of I here? We have got E into R1 plus R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 into plus R1 R2. This is what we have achieved. So if you compare this with the previous answer, here we have calculated the value of E is equal to BVL, and what was the I value? It was E into R1 plus R2, E into R1 plus R2 divided by R into R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. Okay. substituting the value of E is equal to BVL, you will get the value of I. Once you get the value of I, you can find out the value of I1 and I2. So basically you have to understand the procedure. I have done the same derivation in two ways, whether you use Kirchhoff rule or whether you use the motional EMF concept, you will end up with the same answer. Okay, so practice this and solve any numerical on this. Normally this formula you don't have to memorize, some numerical will be given. So understand the procedure and apply it.